the Brazilian team playing free, no pressure. Just want to do my best.
Now, we're just going to see here, obviously, Alexandra serving. Now, because of her situation, she can only serve off the racket or the paddle.
Right.
And that, I mean, for obvious reasons, isn't easy because you're having to lift it up and then switch the paddle the way you would want to do it.
Like, right, you're setting up differently, right? And it's not as easy to toss straight, and you can't use your body the same way. So her serves are not going to be as spinny. And she has to compensate for that in the rest of her game.
They're looking to join five other athletes who have qualified for both Para and Olympics.
In the same games.
Yeah, it's quite an achievement. Ishiyon has had a great start here.
Bruna Alexander also improving greatly. I mean, the whole Brazilian team has been playing awesome.
It's tough, isn't it? This is going to be a big battle. I'll tell you about Bruna Alexandra's results. She beat Layla Edwards of South Africa in three straight games. Great start to her event here. Then she beat Tessie Gonderinger 3-1. That's a fantastic result.
Very good win.
She seems to have now just started to get a bit more of a flow here. Second point on the board. She was up against Miu Hirano. And actually took one of those games to 8.
That was a great rally of Bruna Alexander.
Against Iran's Shima Safai, she won that 3-2 overall, including a 16-14. And earlier today, in the round of 32. She beat Bernadette Ballant 3-0. So a very good event for her.
She's winning a lot. She has more wins than a lot of other players at this event.
Yeah, she does.
3-9.
But Ishiyon has started off excellently here. Again, you have another illustration of how it is with her for serving, Bruna Alexandra.
Watch, she balances it on her paddle and throws it.
And quite often I've noticed when it's up in the air, it kind of comes in towards her as well sometimes.
It's a little harder to go straight.
It's trickier, isn't it? Right.
10-4.
6 game points now for Ishiyon. Good power there.
And I love the crowd. Oh.
So first game, Ishiyon, the winner of this tie, by the way, gets the privilege of playing China next. It's going to be a whole different ball game.
It's important to note that Japan going through, although not unexpected, they do secure their quota spot.
True.
Ishiyon is a very powerful player, and it's difficult for someone like Bruna Alexander, who wants to play more defensively, more tricky.
1-2.
A little bit harder.
How far back she's had to go.
3-1.
I mean, when she was at the Pan American Games, which you were at as well, Barbara, I mean, there were experts saying that it's not easy for her because of the movement. She's kind of limited in the movements. Mm-hmm.
The balance is different.
The balance is also different, correct. No, she said she's never known what it's like to have an arm. She lost her arm at three.
3 months.
3 months, I should say. Excuse me, yes.
3 months.
So she will join another player, Natalia Patyka from Poland, who has also played in the Olympics and the Paragames.
Yes. So Bruna Alexander has already secured her spot in the Paralympics,
yes.
And now Brazil has that quota spot, so she's looking to secure it in her own home selection process.
Yeah. Yeah, tremendous. 3-3 here.
Wow.
Oh, fantastic shot.
It is really tough because he's not easy. She's in the middle. She can change the direction. And Bruno Takahashi says, yes, thank you.
Oh, she's frustrated with that one, Alexandra.
Ishan varying the placement of her attacks, trying to go very wide, perhaps taking advantage of some of the movement, the challenges of movement for Bruna Alexander. Almost had it, Bruna.
Yeah, not far away.
It was pretty close.
Yeah, starting to pull away now, Ishion.
Hey, four.
Ishion very measured, very much saying, I'm going to serve, I'm going to loop wide, I'm going to go to the other corner, taking advantage, I think, of some of the movement challenges.
Intense discussions between the two sisters. Oh, fantastic again.
Finishing backhand.
Bruno Takahashi just walking off now, getting ready for the next match. Only 2 points in it.
Defensive play by Bruna Alexander, really tricky. I mean, this is not easy to defend against. Yulia Takahashi looking pleased with that. Ishan just having more shots than Bruna Alexander can return. Bruna Alexander is really with it, you know, first three, four shots, but then Ishan just keeps going.
Night seven.
Two points still, Ishan. Good defense here. Oh, not far away.
10-7.
I mean, Ishiyan is really working for these points.
Yeah.
This is not a steamrolling match. Great touch by Bruna Alexander.
Three game points here for Ishiyan.
Getting some moisture off the table. Anything wet on the table can impact the bounce of the ball.
10-7.
Mm.
8-10.
Saves one, Alexandra.
Alexander's backhand flip is quite strong. She uses her backhand a lot.
Keeping it alive, Alexandra!
Wow.
An Olympic medalist, one silver and two bronzes from the Paralympics in Rio and Tokyo.
And she is very experienced as a player. She has played double the amount of matches.
Right. Oh, it took an edge.
Oh, an edge. All right, off the edge.
Second apology there.
Sorry. Making sure you heard me, sorry. Ishiyan just so solid. Mm. Not a lot of unforced errors, really just here, let me hit it wide. Her strategy has really been to hit wide on Bruna Alexander.
It's happened quite a bit, hasn't it?
Sorry.
Sorry, not sorry.
Sorry, but I'll take it.
Yeah.
You shouldn't be like, oh man, when will I get one of those? Bruna Alexander very good in the middle. But Ishiyan just too powerful, I feel like. Again.
She's, look, as a third player, it's a good option, isn't it, for Korea. And many of these teams here will struggle with a third player.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but the Korean team is so deep.
Yeah. Does well in the serve there, Ishiyan.
Right into the middle and the curved a little bit into Bruna Alexander's body.
Again, pulling away here, Ishiyan.
I just feel like Ishiyan is just too powerful, too consistent. Outplaying Bruna Alexander in this match.
That's a big 5-point cushion now, or a lead rather than a cushion. It's pretty comfortable for Ishiyan. Can she finish this off and give Korea the all-important 2-1 lead?
Ooh.
She was watching her for a while, wasn't she?
That was pretty amazing to see. Watch Camila Alexander, she goes farther and farther behind. And then she starts running towards the table.
Yeah, looking to put the pressure on.
That was fun to watch. Oh, such great touch.
Fantastic there.
Court nine.
From Alexander. Lovely winner from her on the forehand. And that's done.